when it's only Monday, and the driver knows my name. Yeah, I hope that I am on your mind. My head's out the window tonight, staying up till the club shut down. Yeah, I work too much, so I had to get out. Tell me where you wanna go. Back to your place, I don't mind. My head's out the window tonight. I don't wanna go home. Let's go somewhere we've not been before.
Good morning, YouTube. It is Thursday, July 6th. And that means it's been 4 months since I've created a video. But I have some mangoes in this pretty little bowl for breakfast. And I got my coffee. And I'll probably eat more in like an hour, so I'm just not like super starving at the moment. But I'm gonna eat my breakfast, and then I'll probably take Louie on a walk and get a little workout in. And I have a sorority function later, and yeah. This mango is so good. It was like so ripe. So when I went to Haiti, I went twice the past 2 summers. I wasn't able to go this summer. One of their things for breakfast is they would serve us fresh mangoes in this big old bowl, and so you just scoop them in a bowl. And like, that is what I had for breakfast. I would go back for seconds and just eat all the mangoes, all of them. Because in Haiti, they're just so fresh, and they're like bright orange. Like, these are kind of a yellowy orange. What is the lighting doing? Better? Maybe? Anyways, the mangoes in Haiti are like bright orange, and they are so flavorful, and they're so sweet, and oh my gosh, it's just so good. And so that was just a nice little reminder this morning. I miss Haiti. I'll go back soon, but it's a good breakfast. Okay, so what I wanted to talk about today was my experience with coaching, kind of. So first off, my experience with coaching, what I'm doing currently, what the past 4 or 5 months have looked like for me, and just kind of future plans. So the past 4 or 5 months have kind of been like up and down, like in life in general has been freaking awesome. Like I got into nursing school, I moved into a new house. I'm just so grateful for everything going on in my life right now. And I'm just happy as a clam. And, but there's been kind of a lot of like I had to go home and work for 2 weeks. And so like, I didn't have access to a gym at home. And now that it's summer, you have to pay, like I mentioned earlier, I'm not taking summer classes because I literally have nothing left to take other than what's provided in nursing school. So I would have to pay to use our rec center, which it's not that expensive, but just for right now, like it's gonna have to wait another week for me to use it. And like, so I don't have access to that gym right now. Like I said, I've been doing like just some Kayla Itzine stuff or just my own little workouts, or I'll do like Whitney Simmons at home workouts, just stuff like that. So I'm staying active, or I'm going running, or just in general, like I haven't been like stagnant or not doing anything or not pursuing fitness. I've been trying really hard to eat a paleo-based diet, but then there's times like I went to go see my boyfriend in Midlothian this past weekend, and like it just wasn't an option to like spend the extra money to get healthier foods, because of course he doesn't stock his fridge with stuff like that, and it wasn't on my mind. It was not an enormous desire for me to like go out of my way to cook my own foods before I did anything that day so that I would have foods throughout the day. So I still make healthy choices, but at the same time, like I'm not gonna like go completely out of my way to like make sure I'm sticking to the diet that I do when I'm at home and I'm able to make my own foods and make those own choices for myself, rather than like being the only one at a 4th of July party that doesn't that's not eating a freaking hamburger. Like, this is not my desire. So, just like little things like that, like that's, I mean, I know that's called balance, but at the same time, like, it's just kind of like living. It's not even like the concept of balance, it's just the concept of like day-to-day life in general. So like when I can, and for the most part, probably 70%, I'm eating awesome, I'm eating well, and fueling my body, and maybe I'm working out 3 or 4 times a week. That's kind of like what's going on. And so I haven't been lifting near as much, which honestly, I didn't step foot in a gym for a month. And I can tell you I needed that. And so that kind of goes into like my conversation about my experience with a coach. So my coach was awesome. He didn't do anything wrong. Like I'm not gonna tell you who it was, just because like he's awesome, he's doing fine, like power to him. Everything, any issue that I had with coaching was me. And it's because I had the realization one day that like I don't enjoy being coached. I genuinely, like, my life is everywhere. Like I said, like all of these things, like having to go back to Austin for 2 weeks or going to visit my boyfriend on the weekends that I can, like it's not, I'm so all over the place that being coached right now is kind of like out of the question. Like it's kind of illogical for me to like, how do I say it? Being coached is not something that I'm able to do with this point in my life, I guess you want to say. Like I'm not able to hit macros every single day, and that's like, that's fine with me. I don't care. Like I don't want to be miserable in counting macros, so I don't count macros. If you thrive off macros, or if that's how you're starting your journey, freaking go for it. Like they're an awesome tool, and they, so many people are able to see such good progression while counting their macros, because it gives you a tool to be able to see your progress, and it gives you something to adjust if progress isn't happening. But for me, that's not, I can't track macros. I don't want to, I don't like to, I'm not good at it. I forget about it, I don't think about it, so I'll just eat something and then forgot what I ate. But for me, it's so much easier for me to make conscious, healthy choices because I want to eat good foods. Like I crave good foods. So it's so much easier for me to, like, at the grocery store, I only buy like whole foods. And if I buy foods that aren't whole, they're like a granola bar or like Chobani yogurt, which is healthy, yes, but it's not like purposely paleo, or because it's dairy. I still eat dairy. I still have my toast in the morning. And so I think I'm like in the process of finding what works for me best. And that for me is making conscious decisions and staying active. Like it just boils down as being simple as that. I wanted so bad, I wanted to do a bikini competition. So that's why I pursued getting a coach. And I tried really hard to do weekly check-ins and everything. And like, it came to the point where multiple weeks I was like, I have nothing to give you because I couldn't follow this today. Or I didn't have the energy to go through and track everything every day. And that has nothing on my coach. That's me. That's me realizing that that's not something that's for me. And I used to see posts about girls saying like, bikini competing isn't for everyone. I'd be like, you know what, girl, it's for me. No, it totally is not for everyone. And just my schedule in general and being in college, and like I'm about to start nursing school and going to clinicals and traveling up to like an hour and a half in the morning just to get to my clinical and spend all day there. Like, yeah, it's probably gonna be easier to pack a meal then, but it's not feasible for me to like try my hardest to like start something like prep. Like, so competing is no longer a goal of mine. And if you follow me on Instagram, like it was something I talked about that I wanted to do and everything, but it's just not a goal of mine anymore. Which is fine, like whatever. And I also haven't posted a video in a long time because I haven't had anything to post. And honestly, going back through my videos, I kind of like shoved content in and I rushed to put them up just because I wanted to get a video up and I liked the idea of creating vlogs. But at the same time, like I wasn't providing much. And like, I'll be the first to say that like my vlogs, they weren't anything but just kind of like entertainment, which is fine. Like I'm not saying that I'm some fitness guru that's gonna give you information that no one else can, or that my vlog, you should watch my vlogs over someone else's. I just honestly wanted to join the like the fitness YouTube community, and so that's what I did. I just jumped in and I created vlogs and I videoed my life. I videoed my workouts, which were not perfect. My form isn't perfect. I always claimed that I wasn't gonna have perfect form though, because I don't. I was never taught how to train well, or I was never trained on like perfect form or anything. Like, it was just me trying things out in the gym, watching videos, doing what felt good for my body. And so when I put those in a vlog, like, my vlogs are not perfect. Like, there are so many other awesome people to watch. And so I think I kind of, that got in my head, and I was like, why do people want to watch my vlogs? Like, I don't offer anything except for me and my daily entertainment. And so I stopped posting, and I didn't have a desire to vlog. I got to the point where I was like more uncomfortable than I had been videoing in the gym, just because it was like, I'm not motivated to promote my workouts, so why would I video them? And so I just kind of stopped vlogging. But then last night I was like, you know what? Like, I want to talk about my fitness. I want to talk about the things that like I've gone through in the past couple of months, which aren't even bad things. It's just like a change of plans and a change of strategics, I guess you could say. And so I wanted to talk about that, and so that's why I created this video. And who knows, maybe I'll start vlogging more often. But at the same time, like, school's gonna start in another month. Like, I'm going on a trip with my friends, and I probably won't get a whole lot of video content out there, or I'll be on a roll and I'll put like 3 videos up in a week. I don't know, but I wanted to make this here to talk about why I'm not posting as much fitness stuff on Instagram, why I changed my Instagram handle to not be posting fitness stuff as much and not be like a fitness Instagram. And then today, literally decided this 30 minutes ago, I was in the bathtub and I was like, you know what? I still wanna post fitness stuff. And so I like created a fitness Instagram. And so that's just like my other handle, it's devanjfit. So go follow that one. Who knows if I'll post all the time like I did last time. I don't have any desire to promote a company just to get more followers like I used to, because I used to think that there was like a certain way to do everything in the fitness community. And I don't know if I'm the only one that thought that, or I don't know if I'm the only one that like has said something about that. Surely not. But like, I thought like, I never thought that a bikini competition was the next step. I just thought it was something I wanted to do. So I decided I wanted to start a fitness Instagram, promote a company, and I loved my protein. I really did. Like, I'm like, there's nothing stopping me from like buying their products. They just like kind of ex-nade their student ambassador group and didn't really tell anyone. So that was kind of dumb on their part, but you know, whatever. So that's why I stopped promoting them, which is fine. I have nothing against their products, just kind of have no desire to like, post about them anymore, you know what I mean? So like, I don't have any desire to like advertise for a supplement company or whatever. So I'm just like created a new fitness Instagram, which is basically the same one, to post things from like here on out. I don't want to look at my fitness stuff as I was doing really well and then I got a coach and I totally fell off track because I didn't know what I was doing and I didn't enjoy it, and eating to bulk like really messed up my progress. Not that, I guess it's like a trust the process kind of thing, but at the same time it messed up my mindset and I was not okay with that. So I'm kind of just pursuing like I said, like a healthier lifestyle. Just like staying active and eating well, trying really hard to be paleo based because I enjoy it. But I didn't want my Instagram to be like, this is where I started. This is me like trying to have a coach and not enjoying it. And then this is my kind of after my 2 months of having a coach time period. And so yeah, fitness. No, like I didn't want that. And so I went back to a personal Instagram, started a new one as of 30 minutes ago, and I'm just gonna post fitness stuff. Like, and so follow me if you want, girl. But it's not, I just don't know if I want, I don't know necessarily how, I don't necessarily know if I want to jump in feet first into the fitness community like I was trying to. that's why I created a new Instagram, just to kind of post whatever I wanted about fitness stuff, and then just continue to follow my personal one if you want, girl, but I probably won't post like a lot of fitnessy type stuff. But that's what I wanted to talk about. I wanted to talk about kind of what was going on, why I wasn't posting videos, my experience with the coach, and like what I'm doing forward. And like I said, what I'm doing from here forward is just kind of like pursuing an active lifestyle. I still want to be in the gym when I can go ahead and like start a membership at our gym. I still want to lift. I enjoy lifting, just not as hardcore as I was like trying to go for it. I just don't think that I thrive off of always being in a gym lifting. So, but that doesn't mean I don't enjoy lifting. I guess if you want to go, that doesn't mean I don't enjoy lifting. So just being active, listening to my body, and just pursuing whole foods and an active lifestyle. And that's just what I'm doing. It's just what I've been doing. And I'm excited to kind of like have put these words out there, because I feel like, no, I don't know anyone, any kind of explanation on why I stopped posting fitness stuff. You know, does anyone care? I don't know. I don't care if you don't care. But I just wanted to, for me, I wanted to put those words out there. But I just want to put those words out there to get back in my groove. This is on my phone because my camera died. But give it a like, subscribe. Bye, friends. I come alive when we're together. I'm alive.